Hello guys, welcome to my channel Kevin Sir. So in today's class we are going to discuss more about some basic concepts of chemistry chapter from class 11. So in this chapter we are going to discuss about the topic of prefixes involved in our SI units. So usually when we take a SI unit, let us say a meter for distance, so that meters might be having a kilometer or megameter or centimeter, something like that. So if you consider for a short length, the scales which we use in our classrooms, it is a 15 centimeter scales, right? So those scales we say centi because of its lengthwise. Actually, if you say this is, let's say this is a distance for about 1 meter, so this is 1 meter of distance, we cannot always use 1 meter for everything in order to measure everything. So what we do is we reduce them or we increase those meters by using specific prefixes. Like for example, if you have to measure the size or radius of an atom, we need to use a smaller meter variations. So those smaller meter variations may have some exponentials or multiples attached to them, prefixes to them. Like for example, if I say radius of an atom is in nanometer, that is, it has something like 10 power minus 9 amount of meters. Say its radius is 3.21 into 10 power minus 9 meter. So now, instead of saying 3.21 into 10 power minus 9 meter every time, what we do is, we use this multiple and give a specific prefix for that. So instead of writing 3.21 into 10 power minus 9 meter, what we do is, we can write this as 3.21 nanometer, nanometer, denoted by the symbol nm, where n for the nano, m for the meter. So in a similar way, all the physical quantities which we have discussed in the yesterday's class can carry a suitable prefixes in them. So those prefixes are nothing but the multiples of 10 power something. It might be positive, it may be negative. So those exponentials present on the powers of 10 can be given a specific prefix for them, and those prefixes can be denoted by specific symbols. So those list is what I have written in the board. So these are the total number of prefixes, different every type of prefixes which we usually use for our scientific studies. So that starts from 10 to the power minus 24 to 10 to the power plus 24. So it varies from 10 to the power minus 24 to 10 to the power plus 24. If you have any physical quantities SI unit having a multiple in this order, now let us say I have a value 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 21 meters of length. 4.5 to 10 to the power minus 21 meters of length. So what you have to do is, first you take down 4.5 as it is, and instead of into 10 to the power minus 21, instead of taking it as 10 to the power minus 21, we need to check for the prefix suitable with 10 to the power minus 21. So that is 10 power minus 21, which is given as a prefix zepto of symbol Z. So instead of writing 4.5 into 10 power minus 21 meters, what we can write is 4.5 into 4.5 ZM. So this is 4.5 zeptometer. Okay, so this is how we use. If you have to check for weight, something like that, so the bytes of memory, in case of the memory cards what we use, let us say we have 64 GB of data. So 64 GB of data. 64 GB of data. So that means usually we have bytes, GB, capital B. So that means we have 64 into 10 to the power 9 bytes of data. That is 64 into 10 to the power 9 bytes of data. So this is how we can convert our given multiple into a symbol and a symbol into a multiple. If you are given a multiple in symbol values, let us say it is given in nanometer, so it's nothing but you have to multiply the given number with 10 power minus 9. If you are given the value, let us say millimeter, what we usually measure for our cloth values. So 10 millimeter, that means 10 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. Okay, so this is how we take the prefixes. So first we'll go through all those prefixes and their respective multiples and the symbols. First is 10 power minus 24, which is given the prefix octa, octo, symbol y. Okay, this is almost similar to the 10 power 24 value, but that is yotta, this is yokto. Okay, next 10 power minus 21, zepto, given by the symbol z. 10 power minus 18, atto, small lowercase a. 10 power minus 15, femto, f. 10 power minus 12, pico, p. So this p we usually use for our solid states. 10 power minus 9, nano, n, which we usually use for wavelengths. 10 power minus 6, micro, given by the symbol mu. 10 power minus 3, milli, given by the symbol mm. Don't confuse this m with our normal meter. If you have given millimeter, that means mm. Okay, we have two m's, one for milli, one for meter. And we have, if you have 10 power minus 2, that means centi, given by the symbol lowercase c. 10 power minus 1, deci, given by the symbol d. 10 power 1, this 10 means 10 power 1. So if you have just 10 power 1, that will be deca, da. 10 power 2, hecto, given by the symbol h. 10 power 3, given by the symbol. 10 power 3, it means kilo, given by the symbol k. And 10 power 6, mega, given by the symbol capital M. 10 power 9, giga, symbol g. 10 power 12, tera, symbol t. 10 power 15, peta, symbol p. 10 power 18, exa, symbol e. And the last two, 10 power 21, zeta, with capital Z. And 10 power 24, yotta, with symbol capital Y. In case of, if you have kilograms or grams of meters, so we know the SI unit of meter and mass, meters is M, and that of mass is kilogram, right? So what we usually use is, instead of writing kilograms for a given value, we calculate them as grams and we use kilo as a 10 power 3. Even though kilogram is the SI unit of mass or weight, it is SI unit of mass, what we use is we use mass in the smaller terms, that is in grams. We don't use kilograms usually for the SI unit, even though it is an SI unit. Kilogram is an SI unit of mass. We use just grams but not kilograms. That is because kilo is considered as a prefix for mass. Okay, so this is about the different multiples and prefixes which can be used, which we can use for certain given SI units of physical quantities. Okay, now for measurements of our physical quantities. So in the previous videos we have discussed about the different physical quantities which we use. Now we are going to discuss about specific physical quantities which we usually use in our laboratory. So those are mass, weight, volume, density, temperature. So what are the physical quantities which you usually use in our laboratories are, first one, mass and weight. Second one being volume. Third one is the density. And fourth one is our temperature. So these are the four physical quantities which we usually and commonly use in our laboratory. We don't use luminous intensity or radiant intensity, etc. What we usually use are these four physical quantities for explaining a physical property of a given substance. So if we start with one after the other, first we'll discuss about mass and weight. So what is a general myth is, we always consider mass and weight as similar physical quantity, but it is not the same. Mass and weight are not at all similar to one another. Mass is because of the amount of substance given. Mass arises because of the amount of substance occupying a certain space. If a substance is occupying certain space in a given geometry, that is explained in the terms of mass, whereas weight is explained as mass experienced by the substance and also by acceleration due to gravity. That is nothing but weight is usually called as the force extended or the force imparted by the substance due to gravity. That is, we define weight as multiple of mass into acceleration due to gravity, g. That is, weight is equal to m into g, that is weight is due to because of the mass of the substance and the force it is exhibiting, okay, and the force it is extending on the earth. So that is the weight of a substance. That means a mass of a substance will not be equal to weight of the substance, provided if it is gravity due to acceleration is 1. So on earth, if you have to know the mass of certain weight of a certain substance, you need to know the mass of the substance. Let us say I'm taking 1 kilograms of a substance. So then weight of that 1 kilogram of substance will be 1, mass is 1 kilogram into acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meters per second. So the complete weight will be 9.8 kg meter per second, which is also called as 9.8 Newton. That is the force experienced by the substance. Okay. So what we have to say is weight is always the force pushed by the substance on earth when we are keeping them in a certain place. Whereas mass is because of the amount of the substance present. Okay. Mass and weight are not at all same. Mass is denoted by the symbol small m, whereas weight is denoted by the symbol capital W. And W and m are related by the equation W is equal to mg. Weight is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity. Okay. So this is what becomes between mass and weight. So this mass and weight usually carry a SI unit of gram, meter and second. As I said just before now, we consider mass as grams. Even though SI unit of mass is kilograms, we usually use the term grams because in laboratory we use very smaller minute amounts. That is, if we have to react some substance with other reactant in order to give a product, we usually take the value in grams but not in kgs. Okay. We don't use huge masses in order to convert the reactant into a product. What we take is minute amount of grams. Let us say that, for example, 2.3 grams or something like that. We don't use kilograms of components or reactants to convert them into products in laboratory. But in large scale industries, we do take them in kilograms. But in chemical laboratories, we usually use gram mass of the substances. Okay. So mass and weight are nothing but mass is the amount of substance present, whereas weight is the force force exerted by the substance. Okay. So this is about mass and weight. And what we usually take is in laboratories, we use grams as the unit for mass measurement. Okay. Next is volume measurement. Next we are going to discuss about is measurement of volume. Second one, volume. So volume, for volume, what we consider is we take two parts in it. One is because of solid and second one is the volume of liquid and gases. If you are considering for a solid, so volume of solid is denoted by the SI unit. Volume of solid is given by the SI unit meter cube, that is cubes of meter. As we know, volume's formula is length into breadth into height. So if you are taking volume in terms of for solid, we take it as meter cube. So cubes of meter. In case of volume of liquid or gas, what we consider is we take SI unit as liter. Even though the volume of a substance is considered as a meter's value, we don't usually take meters for liquids or gases for its volume. What we take is liters, denoted by the symbol capital L. This liters is equal to 1000 milliliter, that is 1000. So we know milli, that is 10 to the power minus 3. So we have 10 to the power plus 3 into 10 power minus 3. Liters, therefore there is nothing but liter again. So in the same way, we take 1000 centimeter cube equal to 1 decimeter cube. So 1000 centimeter cube for 1 dm cube, for the calculation of volume. Okay, so this is how we consider our values of volume of liquid and solid. Next, we are going to discuss about the measurement of density. So, density of a substance is defined as the ratio of mass to volume. That is, in specific, if you have to define a density, density defines the mass occupied by the substance per unit volume. If you take 1 meter cube of volume of a substance, if you are considering 1 meter cube volume of a substance, the mass of that 1 meter cube volume of the substance is taken as the density of the given substance. So let us say x mass, x grams of a substance is taken for 1 meter cube of its volume. So then the density is given by, density d is given by x gram per meter cube, x gram per meter cube. So that is density of a substance, density of a substance is equal to mass of the substance divided by volume of the substance. It may be a gas, it may be a liquid, or it may be a solid. So density is given by the equation mass of a substance divided by volume of a substance. Density is equal to mass of the substance taken divided by volume of that substance. So if you have to define it, what we say is density of a substance is the mass of the substance occupying by the 1 meter cube of its volume. So even though we take SI unit of substances mass as kilograms, in general aspects of laboratory, we won't use kilograms of substances. What we usually do is we take gram per cm cube. Gram per cm cube. Instead of using the SI units of kilogram mass as kilograms and SI unit of volume as meter cube, we consider mass of a substance as unit grams and volume of the substance in the units of centimeter cube. Okay, so this is again the same thing. It doesn't matter which you are, what you are denoting, but instead of taking kilograms per meter cube, what we take is we take grams per centimeter cube, because we deal with the density in a minute races. So therefore, density of a substance is usually denoted as gram per centimeter cube. So this is about our measurement of density. So next, we are going to discuss about the temperature measurement. Next is the last one, temperature. So we know the temperature SI unit is Kelvin, right? So the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. Even though we use Kelvin as the SI unit of temperature, we have two more units of measurements for temperature. Those are degree Celsius, denoted by 0C, not C, and other one is degree F, that is Fahrenheit. So we have, along with Kelvin, we have two more units of temperature measurements. One is Celsius, other one is Fahrenheit. So here, Kelvin, Celsius and Fahrenheit are related with one another in order to have a common temperature readings. So how we do that is, we take Celsius as our basic temperature measuring unit. We take Celsius as our basic measuring temperature unit. So therefore, we can relate Kelvin with Celsius and again Fahrenheit with Celsius. So how can we do that is, Kelvin of a temperature is equal to Celsius of temperature plus 273.16. So if you get a value of Celsius, let us say 70, what you have to do in order to know its Kelvin value is, you need to add 273.16 for the particular degree Celsius value. Usually what we do is, we ignore the point decimal 16 value and just add up 273. Okay, but in order to have an exact value of answers, you need to add 273.16. That is, Kelvin is equal to 273.16 plus degree Celsius value. So if the degree Celsius value of a substance is, let us say, 25, so then Kelvin, the room temperature of our or room temperature on Earth is 25 degrees Celsius, we can take Kelvin is 273 is equal to 25 plus, Kelvin is equal to 25 plus 273.16, that is equals to 298.16 Kelvin. So the temperature in terms of Kelvin scale is 298.16 of room temperature. Okay, so this is how we convert a degree Celsius to a Kelvin scale. For converting a degree Celsius to Fahrenheit scale, what we take is Fahrenheit, 1 Fahrenheit is equal to, so in order to know its Fahrenheit value, we have formula equation as 9 by 5 times degree Celsius value plus 32. 9 by 5 times degree Celsius value plus 32. So this is how we can convert a degree Celsius value of temperature to its respective Fahrenheit. Okay. So usually we use this temperature scale of Fahrenheit for measuring temperature of human bodies, animal things, etc. But usually what we take for the Kelvin temperature measurement is SI as Kelvin. Okay. And further, our degree Celsius scale is arranged from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. So they are aligned themselves in the marking from 0 to, so they are aligned in an order of 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. This is because we are taking here the freezing point of water and the boiling point of water as the initial and the final values for degree Celsius scale of measurement of temperature. So in the temperature measurement under degree Celsius scale, what we use is, we use the freezing point of water as our initial value and boiling point of water as our final value for scale readings. Even though it may rise above 100, we usually take this as for 0 to 100 degrees Celsius, and then we convert them to respective, if you want Kelvin, we can convert them to Kelvin. If you want Fahrenheit, we can convert them to Fahrenheit. Okay. So this is how we use measure our temperature. So this is all about the various physical quantities which we use in our day-to-day life in laboratories. And thus, and in previously, we have discussed about the different types of prefixes which we have to use for certain multiples along with our SI units. Okay. So this is about for today. We'll discuss more in the next class. If you like this video, please do subscribe to my channel and share this among your friends. Thank you for watching.